What do the far right give you? Do you believe everything you read?
I guess you could say that I'd started my journey being radicalised at that point. I thought I was just standing up for my country.
Are other people worried about you?
You think as a parent, you'd know, but you just don't.
I used to be a neo-Nazi, but this isn't my story.
This is my son's story.
This is John's story. The story of young people in the far right. Some of what you're about to hear is not easy to listen to because it involves children being manipulated to hold abhorrent views.
Speak to the average person in the UK about extremism and they might discuss jihadists. But right now, in police forces across the country, there is a rising fear about right-wing extremism and about how groups are involving children.
This is John. We're using an actor to disguise his voice.
Is there still a risk to you, you know, talking publicly about the groups that you were part of?
I think there is still that risk, yeah. There's always that risk element when you leave the far right and talk against them. So, yeah, that's why I'm more comfortable with being anonymous. My first memory of the far right was when I was about 14. I had a friend from school who was already in a far right group and he would show me stuff from sites on his phone. Initially, the main attraction was how patriotic they were. A lot of the people in the far right said they were standing up for soldiers in the UK, which is something that I've always felt very passionate about.
But the people John met on these sites virtually groomed that initial sense of patriotism into something much more dangerous.
At that point, I think the enemy in our minds was Islam, was the Muslim people. I sort of felt at the time that I was almost better than them, almost like we were worth more than them. There was one particular assistant teacher at the school who we did almost target. She had one of her parents had Pakistani heritage and she had darker skin than me and my friend in school. And we'd say things like, "You're not really British. You shouldn't be allowed a British passport. And when we get power, we're not going to allow people like you to have a job. We're going to give the jobs to white British people."
And where do you think that feeling came from? Is that what you were sort of being told by what you had read, for example?
Yeah, I think it did. It really did come from reading what I did on these forums and these sites.
John sunk deeper into the far right, attending demonstrations, some violent. He tried to recruit others and became known to the police, all the while viewing hours of online content every day.
Far-right propaganda, some of it less extreme, some of it even more so, can be found across the internet. And a lot of this content uses the Union Jack or the St. George's flag to try and manipulate this sense of patriotism. And even sites that moderate this sort of content struggle to keep up because the far-right is extremely adaptable online. As soon as one account is closed, there's another with a new name ready to open.
And age is no barrier to recruiters. This is our research into children referred to government counter-extremism programmes. And look at this. Since 2015, numbers linked to the far right went up more than five times in just 4 years, including children under the age of 10. And this is from February from a forum for an extreme far right group. "How old are you, mate?" one person asks another. 13, the child says. "I can tell. Also, you spelt fascist wrong in your name. You forgot the S. Are you willing to fight for fascism?" he goes on. "No, I'm 100%. But another young user adds, "Can you describe what fascism is?"
I think the far right in Britain today, if I'm honest from my point of view, is actually its most dangerous it's ever been.
Nigel Bromage was a neo-Nazi, a member of several extreme far right groups. But now he helps de-radicalise people, including the very young.
The youngest person we've actually helped and supported has been 9 years of age. That to me really shocked me. He then basically identified the person who was recruiting him in and getting him to watch neo-Nazi video games was actually his older brother.
Today, far-right recruitment is happening online, where content is deliberately targeted at a younger audience, encouraging them to take direct action.
And those video games are just like many other games with regard to chasing and shooting people. But what, when you look at the sort of content of the game, what you'll do then is you'll see that the people who are being chased are from people from different ethnic communities, different religions.
When you were chatting on these forums, did people know that at this time you were 14?
Well, we never came out and said our age. We never said that we was 14, 15, 16 going through school, but from the way that we were talking and how sort of inexperienced in life we were, it wouldn't have been too hard to figure out. I just think we were sort of the next generation of people coming in. We were going to be the people that took over from them, so I think they sort of made that extra effort to make you feel welcome and make you feel sort of accepted into the group, really.
When you look back on everything that you were involved in, how does it make you feel?
Massively ashamed. And you can't really apologise enough for what sort of stuff you got involved with and the things you said, but yeah, just overall, just really ashamed of everything.
And there is more evidence that an ideology spawned and propagated online is spilling into real life. 17-year-old Paul Dunleavy was jailed this month for preparing a terrorist act. He said his hero was Adolf Hitler. And Harry Vaughan, an A-star student from London, got a suspended sentence after posting bomb-making manuals to a neo-Nazi forum.
With the far right now, there is no stereotype. We speak to everybody from working-class backgrounds all the way through to people who've got professional moms and dads. Because of the internet and online accessibility, anybody now can actually succumb to the far-right message.
And parents and peers report frequently not knowing what their children have become involved with. Like John's mum, Sarah, we've disguised her voice.
To find out that that's been going on under your roof while you've been sat in the next room, it's absolutely soul-destroying. Because you've no idea what's going on. I thought he was online with his friends. At 16, do you stand and look over the shoulder? I never thought for a second anything else was going on. Because you think as a parent, you'd know. But you just don't.
What is it about the far right that you think is appealing to young people?
It's because of that sense of belonging, really. A lot of young people want to feel like they're part of something. And that is something that the far right will offer them. At the time, I definitely remember that sense of excitement. You know, sort of thinking that I was part of this elite organisation that not many people liked. But I always thought it's only going to be a matter of time before people realise we're actually the good people. And have people start joining in, and I would just be the sort of the first one out of my friendship group to do it. And then everyone else would come to me and ask me to get them involved.
But after a public outburst in class, John's college referred him to a government counter-extremism programme that slowly changed his ideology.
What do you think would have happened to John if he hadn't had that intervention?
He would have been in prison because he was just getting more and more brazen and more daring. And he was getting deeper and deeper and wanting to impress and things like that. And I think he would have had a criminal record. His life would have been over.
Do you think there would have ever been a point where you would have supported some sort of direct action, some violent action, even if you weren't involved in it personally, but do you think it could have got that extreme?
I think it's very, very hard to answer that question because I was very much against that sort of extreme violence at the time. However, if I had been involved for all them extra years, there's a chance that that sort of mindset would have come to me in the end. So as much as I want to say no, it could have got to that stage.